Hi guys, how are you? My name is Pia and welcome to my channel, Thrifty Pia. I am a part-time seller online. I sell for eBay, Poshmark, Amazon. Today is Wednesday, April 7th. I had an email the other night that Savers had a 50% off on media and books, and I do make half of my income online with mostly media and books on Amazon, sometimes on eBay, depends on the topic. So I thought I would just stop by today and see if we could get us some money. So what I'm going to do, because I don't film when I do thrifty shopping, only because I don't have a body cam, I don't have anywhere to hide the cam, and people know when you have a cell phone out when you're filming them, I just don't want to run into any trouble with anybody. So if I can, I will try to do a little bit of filming if I'm in a section by myself. If not, then you guys will just see what I got when I get home, and then we can go over the prices and why I picked these titles up and why I think they could be sold. So let's go get us some money today at Savers. Next day, so I was able to film a little bit, as you guys would see in the previous clip, and I just want to give you a small little hint. When you go out to either Savers or Salvation Army store, sometimes it's not always about like how much money you're gonna get to. Look for topics that are top sellers on Amazon. For me, I've been selling books on Amazon for more than 4 years, and I've made a lot of money on Amazon, good money. And topics that always brought me money were medical, history, and weird titles. Weird titles, I say this all the time, weird titles, real topics bring you money. DIY, sewing, fashion, overall. Now, ones that I usually stay away from, and I know people are like, oh, well, Diet books are, some of them are just fades. Like, you know, every year, every month, they come out with a new diet, and they're so oversaturated online. I usually stay away from them because I usually don't get that much for them, unless if it's a really, I haven't really seen a lot of diet books for me that bring me money. I bought a lot of them, and they just sit there. So usually weird titles, history, medical books are ones that bring me money. So I'm very excited to go over what I purchased at Savers. I spent about $18 with the 50% off. I spent only $9.32, which is great for what I got. Everything I picked up, I scanned, except for one book I got for my son. But everything else I got, I scanned it before I left the store. When you go to Savers, don't be embarrassed, because Savers employees and all that they know, sellers go in to buy books. So they, if you're taking out your phone, you're scanning, it doesn't look suspicious. So don't be afraid to do that. One of the worst things you could do is just go to Savers or Salvation Army, so even Goodwill by the pound either too. Just pick up books and not scan them, because you want to scan books that's actually going to bring you money. You don't want to scan books that there's no value to them, because they're just going to sit with those books. And books, guys, collect a lot of space. A lot of space. They take up a lot of room. And sometimes they could take months, years to sell. I have books that took me about 4 to 5 years to actually sell them. That's a lot of space that they're taking. So make sure you scan them. And the other thing too is never pay $4 for books. I've seen some sellers, they're buying books that are $4 or $5. That's too much money. The only time I would pay that much money for a book, if it's going to bring me back a profit of more than $50. You want to buy books where they're half off, like I mentioned before. Savers had basically sent me an email. It was for club members. So when you go to Savers, make sure you sign up for the club memberships, because sometimes you'll get exclusive deals just for members. Because when I went to store yesterday, they did advertise that the media and books were 50% off. So the only way you would know that is if they had sent you an email. So I got the email. I went to the cashier. I told the cashier at first, I have a coupon for the percent. I said, oh, yeah, no problem. I'll skin it at the end. And that's what we did. So I'm just going to go over what I picked up at the store, and then I'll tell you why I picked them up and how much money I think I could sell them for. Now, I know some people are going to say, VHS, there's no money in VHS. If you come across a Barney, pick it up. Certain titles of Barney, like they're really hard to find. Those ones will bring you money. Like this one right now on Amazon, I bought this. It was 49 cents, so I only paid about 20 something cents because I paid half of this, which is a bargain. A lot of the titles that are hard to find could be anywhere from 5 to 20 bucks on Amazon. This one's not going for that much, but with the price I got it for, I did price mine around like $12. I did see some people price theirs at 24, 25, 30. I felt like mine was in mid condition, so like new. There, I've sold VHS Barney tapes for $30, and I don't remember the title. If I could find it, I will put it below. If I don't, then that means I didn't find it. But I've sold some that are really, really hard to find. Those ones I usually bring you money. So if you come across VHS Barneys, pick them up. I've seen people on eBay sell collectors of Barney for a big amount of profit. So if you want to maybe just collect them and just give a whole collection, you could definitely do that. That would also bring you the money. Other book I picked up, mathematical books. Those are good. Books on algebra. Especially now where people are doing a lot of schoolwork from home. If you have a student or a relative or even a child that's struggling with algebra and they don't have the extra like help from a teacher stuff. So sometimes other books will help. And I picked this one up. It's a mathematics handbook for algebra to go. Small book. Very good. It's like new. It does have the writing. I think this book was given out in probably a public school, as you guys could see. This is going for about $70 on Amazon. I did put mine for about 50 bucks only because the condition the book was in. But this is what I'm talking about. Don't under like you have to look at topics, mathematics, history, education. Those books bring you money. This was $3.99. I paid half of that for of I could end up paying like $2 for it. So that was good. Books on finance. Everybody knows her, Susie Orman. Her stuff sells, whether it's a CD, soft book, hard book. Susie Orman shows you how to get money. She also brings you money if you are a seller. So this book right here, because this is like brand new, practically brand new. The reason why I'm not gonna put it new, just because the book's a little bit like just a little bit like bent. But it's like brand new. So this is going for $30, guys. I put mine for about $25 because of the condition that the book was in. But I only paid half of the $4. So I paid $2 for this. Like I said, Susie Orman teaches you how to make money and she brings you money as well. Her stuff sells, whether it's a DVD, a soft book, cover books, all her titles bring you money. Books on finance brings you money. This was a fun little book. Some of these signs I didn't even know them too. And please don't say anything, I'm a driver. But these are I read symbols and they're just road signs. I thought this was a fun book for when Daniel gets older, my son. We could go over the signs and the ones that I don't know, we'll have to look it up, of course. But it's just like different signs and stuff. I thought that was really, really, really interesting. So I got him that. And this was $129. So I paid half of $129, which is good. Books of art literature bring you money. This was fourth edition Living with Art, Rita Gilbert. This one was selling for about $75 new. The previous seller that had it up for that one, their book did not look as new. Mine's practically new. I put mine for around four, not four, around $50 to $60. I don't remember the price, but I think I did around $50 to $60 margin. I figured that was a fair price. Again, this was $3.99. I paid $2 for it. The reason I'm showing you guys topics that go for a lot of money at Amazon, because if you come across these topics, you could basically make money. And the other thing too, I mentioned this many times in my videos, sometimes the condition section on Amazon could make or make you lose money, depending on how you list the book. A lot of times, someone to list a book new, they think the book has to be 100% new. That's not true. I mean, like new, inside is brand new, but the cover is not. So that would be a conditions like new. And you could get that, maybe not the full price, but half a price, because someone's probably willing to, like, well, I'd rather pay $50 and pay $100 because this one just has a few scrapes on it. Not a big deal. So, you know what I mean? So, those are the things you have to look out for. And I have one more to show you guys. So, this was a big one. Second edition, it's Principles of Anatomy and Physiology. A lot of times people will pick books that are second edition or fourth edition, but this book right now is selling for $198 on Amazon. I think I put mine around like 150. Guys, don't underestimate these books because I had people from different parts of the world, from India, China, even South America. They will buy these books, they'll pay for them because maybe where they live, they don't have those type of books. So don't underestimate. If you see the price is going for 198, don't even look at the rank. Just take your chance and buy it, especially when I only paid $2 for this book. So that was a good one. And sometimes you just have to make your own titles and your own categories. So this one, I thought this was a good topic, even though I did not see any listings for it. I only saw one listed on eBay and it was good for $14. It was not sold. I think it's a really good book for nursing. It's called Wound Care Protocols, Choose the Techniques and Product of Healing Wounds Effectively. I think this is very important for anyone who's studying nursing. Maybe you might have a niece or a nephew, or maybe a friend, or maybe a parent of yours that's in nursing school now. And it doesn't matter. Every nurse is going to some part of their career have to deal with wound care. So this book, I was already looking into it. It gives out really good information on wound care and it has quizzes in the back. So I'm going to price this at $40 only because nobody else has it, only one person has it. Sometimes I've sold topics, different topics of health, finance, just DIY books higher, and I've been able to sell them because no one has them. It might take a while, but the right person, if you use the right keywords in your description and you give a good description, you will be able to sell this book. And another thing too, I had another video. I will link it at the end of this video so you guys can watch it. It was basically how to drive traffic into your eBay store. And what I usually do when I create listings like this, I will basically take this title and I will go into Pinterest and I will put something up on Pinterest, some keywords, so I'm searching it, and I will drive them to my store, and that's how I usually make a sale. So yeah, so those are the items I found, guys. I was really excited. Saturday I am going to the Goodwill Outlet by the Pound. I do have a babysitter, which is my mom. I'm so grateful. She's gonna watch Daniel for us. And I will be doing a video of that one probably in a couple of days. I have a lot of videos coming up, so I'm really excited. And if you guys are Savers members, look into your email. Now, I live in Massachusetts, so I don't know if it's different for each state, but make sure you check that email out and make sure you sign up for members for Savers. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. All the information I give out is absolutely free. You don't have to pay anything for it. The only thing I ask for is a subscription. So, bye-bye, guys. I will see you next time. Goodbye.